Okay, students, we have studied the difference between sexual reproduction and asexual reproduction. Later on, we have to study how that lower animals reproduce asexually and that lower animals they reproduce asexually by a gemmal formation and another one is a budding. So here, what is that? That asexual reproduction in animal, that means that animals they reproduces asexually by what is that? First thing is a gemmal formation, that is gemmal formation, and another one is here, this one is a budding. So these are the types of asexual reproduction. These are the types of asexual reproduction. So that animals asexually reproduces by means of a gemmal formation and a budding. Here first of all we will see that one is a gemmal formation. Here that gemmal formation, that one is taking place in a, what is that? Sponges, just like a spongilla. For example, here example is a spongilla. In that spongilla we observe the budding. So what happened? Actually it is an internal bud that is produced by the here sponges in a unfavorable condition. So during the unfavorable condition, what happened? That internal bud, that is nothing but the gemmule, that one is formed by the sponges. Now here these cells, actually there is a formation of a mass of dormant cell, and that mass of dormant cell is called as ericocytes, that is called as a ericocytes. So that ericocytes are formed. When that one is formed? That is formed during the unfavorable condition. So actually it is an aggregation of mass of a cell. And this mass of cell gets surrounded by a membrane that is called as a coating, and that is the thick layer. That thick membrane is formed by the cells, which is secreted by the amoebocytes. So here amoebocytes that secretes, what is that? A thick layer around the cells, that is nothing but the ericocytes. In that one is surrounded. Now what happened? That gemmal formation is to overcome the unfavorable condition. And if there is a favorable condition, that means if there is an occurrence of favorable condition, at that time what happened? That thick layer get ruptured. And then here, on the returning of a favorable condition, gemmule hatches and develops into a new individual. So that is nothing but the here reproduction by means of a gemmule. See here, actually this is the structure of gemmule. That one is a cell here on the inner side. It is an aggregation of a cell. That aggregation of cell, that is called as a ericocytes. That ericocytes are covered with a double layered membrane. This one is a outer membrane and this is the inner membrane. So that is the thick membrane. That one is protecting here ericocytes. Another one thing is that in that gemmule there is presence of, this one is a structure, that is a spicule. That one is a monadzone spicule. So here that one is a monadzone spicules, and another one thing is that here in that membrane there is presence of some cells, and that is nothing but the amoebocytes. And here is the one micropyle. So that micropyle, then that amoebocyte cells, here is the spines, that is monadzone spine, then the cells, that is actually the major part, that is ericocytes, and the inner and outer membrane. So that is the structure here formed, that is called as a gemmule. So that structure is formed during the unfavorable condition by the sponges, and the example is here, what is that? Spongilla. In that spongilla during the unfavorable condition, the mass of cell, that one is formed, which is surrounded by the thick membrane. And when there is an occurrence of favorable condition, at that time what happened? That membrane get ruptured and there will be the release of the cells. That means the new organism, that one is developed, new individual that is developed from this one. So that is called as the budding, sorry, that is called as the spongival formation in the spongula. Then next to that, there is a budding. So what is that budding and how that one is taking place and where it is taking place? See here. Suppose this one is a budding and where that is taking place. Actually, that one is taking place in a that cylindrates. Cylindrates, it is a phylum that consists in the animal just like the hydra. So hydra belongs to cylindrate. In that cylindrate, for example, there is a corals and another one is a hydra. So that budding is exhibited by what is that? There is a hydra and another one is, what is this? This one is a corals. As well as here some colonial acidians, some colonial acidians. So that one is also follow that budding. So what happened in that during the favorable condition here? Suppose this is the body of an hydra. This is a body of an hydra. This one is hydra, consists of body. Then here is a mouth and here is the tentacles. So these are the tentacles. Now what happened during the favorable condition here? Small outgrowth arises on the body of an hydra. So that small outgrowth is nothing but the bud. It is called as a bud. Later on what happened? There is a development of a bud. So that bud gets developed. And here you know that here parent hydra that provides nourishment to the developing that bud. Now that bud increases in the size. As that increases in the size, that also possesses the tentacles. And then later on what happened? When actually it is, what is that now? It is a growing bud. This one is a growing bud. Now it is a growing bud. And here when that bud is fully grown, or one can say when it is capable of a living in an environment independently, then what happened? That get detached from the parent body. So here this is an old hydra. So this one is here old hydra and here is the young hydra. This one is young hydra. So what happened here during the favorable condition? That hydra reproduces by means of a budding. So here outer outgrowth is coming. It is called as an outer budding and this is the inner budding. So inner bud is formed here and here the outer bud is formed. So that bud is formed, that grows in size, that food is getting from the parent body. Later on that one get detached from the parent body. So here is the young hydra, that one is separated. Now here is the parent hydra. Suppose this is the parent hydra. Now here that parent hydra produces the young hydra. So here is the old hydra and that one is a young. So that is nothing but the reproduction. You remember that lower animals reproduces asexually by the zymeal formation as well as a budding. So that Gmail formation, where it is taking place? It is taking place in a sponges. For example, spongilla. That Gmail, it is an internal bud. Here is the outer bud and here is the inner bud. That one is formed in that Gmail condition. So actually Gmail, it is a mass of a cell. So cells get aggregate and that forming the mass of cell, that is called as a adipocyte, which is surrounded by the thick membrane. That thick membrane is secreted by the cells. That is nothing but the amebocytes. And why that one is membrane? That is overcome to the favorable condition. And when there is a occurrence of favorable condition, at that time what happened? That hatches. So here Gmail hatch and develop into a new individual. So this is a Gmail formation. So internal bud, that one is found here. And here is the budding, that is in an hydra and corals, as well as in colonial form of ascidians. So here example is given, hydra. So that hydra reproduces by means of a budding.